Welcome to this session again of energy conservation of management. Today we will further discuss about that some case studies. Myself Anirban Sarkar, assistant professor JIS College of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering Department. Today we will discuss about that caustic soda industry where extraction cum back pressure steam turbines are present, and here some cogeneration systems are also there. A steam turbine cogeneration plant is based on cogeneration system in soda ash manufacturing continuous process chemical plant. The soda ash process is one of the highly energy intensive chemical process requiring power as well as steam almost in same proportion, that is ratio of power to heat would be nearly 1. Generally in soda ash plant the extraction cum back pressure type steam turbine based cogeneration system and fired boiler are found working, providing the best performance result due to achievement of extremely good heat balance due to excellent utilization of energy in two different forms. The high pressure boilers are generally fired with coal or lignite or fuel oil. The case study is provided below is based on the system working in one of the largest soda ash plant existing in Gujarat state. What are the equipments in this captive power plant consisting of major equipments, that is 3 number of extraction cum back pressure single stage turbines. The ratings are two numbers, that is 13,750 kilovolt, that is 11,000 kilowatt single extraction cum back pressure, and another is 1 into 5250 kilovolt ampere, which is 4200 kilowatt, that is double extraction cum back pressure. 4 number of lignite cum coal fired steam generator as per rating provided below, that is 3 numbers into 70 TPH, 105 kg per centimeter square pressure and operating temperature 405 degree centigrade, and another is 1 into 50 TPH, 105 kg per centimeter square and 405 degree centigrade is the operating temperature. So both pressure and operating temperatures are same, only the steam generation rate are different in this boiler, one of the boiler. And cogeneration equipment data, these are all mentioned. Steam turbine generated data, that is type, that is extraction cum back pressure turbine, both 3, that is steam generation unit 1 and 2 are same, that is 2 number, and rating is 11,000 kilowatt. And steam generation unit 3, that is 4200 kilowatt, and the speed are respectively, that is 8250 and 11,500 respectively. So the speed of the stage 3 turbine is more, and reduction gearbox data speed ratio, that is given 8250 by 3000, and for stage 3 turbine 11500 by 1500. Type of gearbox, it is not mentioned here, and inlet steam parameters, that is nearly same, but inlet live steam flow differs from turbine one between turbine 1-2 with turbine 3. That is 135 is TPH is for stage 1 and 2 and 28.5 that is for stage 3. The steam pressure, steam temperature are same, that is 40 kg per centimeter square steam pressure, and steam temperature 380 degree is operating temperature, and steam flow rate is 50 TPH and 2 TPH respectively for stages 1, 2 and 3 respectively. That is first extraction steam parameter. The second extraction steam parameter in the single stage turbine, that is 1 and 2, that is not applicable. But that stage 3 turbine, which is 4200 kilowatt of power generation, has steam pressure of 22 kg per centimeter square and steam temperature 325 degree centigrade, where the steam is extracted or bleeded out, and steam flow, that is 12.8 given. Now some back pressure turbines are also there, that is steam coming from that this main turbine is going to the back pressure turbine. So in this case the steam pressure, that is 22 kg per centimeter square and 280 degree centigrade, and steam flow 85 TPH, and for 4200 kilowatt turbine, that back pressure turbine, that is 2.2 kg per centimeter square, steam temperature 161, and steam flow is 85. If we compare with that is only 13.7 TPH. The generated data rating for apparent power, that is for stage 1 and 2, that is 750 kilovolt, and that is power output as rated power factor, that is 11,000 kilowatt. For stage 3, that is 5250, that is rating of apparent power in kilovolt, and power output at rated power factor, that is 4200. Generation voltage, that is 6600 respectively both, and power factor lag, that is 0.8, with frequency and generator shaft speed varies, that is 3000 in stage 1 and 2 and 1500. Steam generated data again, that is for boiler 1, 2, 3, it is Stokart type, and boiler 4 also Stokart type. Heating surface area, that is MCR, that is steam flow, that is 70 again. So, in case of MCR steam flow, that is pressure and temperatures are same, that is 105 pressure kg per centimeter square and temperature 505 degree centigrade. Flue gas temperature also same, that is entering into the chimney 150 degree maximum. Feed water temperature entering economizer, that is also same, that is 150 degree centigrade. And soot blowers are provided in both case of boiler. Now some fuel specification and other relevant technical data are provided below. Fuel data, that is fuel flow, that is lignite 9.34 metric ton per hour and coal 4 metric ton per hour. So these two type of fuels are actually mixes to generate the power in the boiler. The HCV value, that is higher heating value or calorific value of this lignite and coal respectively, that is 3894 and 5832 kilocalorie per kg respectively. moisture content that is 32.16 and 5.18 respectively. Carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen contents are also given. The most important thing that is sulfur present in lignite fuel that is 2.53% while in coal that is 0.95%. Ash content also relatively low in coal and ratio of fuel maintained for firing that is 70:30, that is 70% is lignite mixing with 30% of coal, and the gross calorific value based on this that is 4200, that is kilocalorie per kg. Now coming to discussion about this normal operating philosophy, the soda ash plant is working round the clock, having very critical continuous chemical process. Interruption of more than half an hour in availability of energy, either in the form of electric power or steam, creates enormous problem in the ongoing process, resulting into substantial production losses. One of the major process areas requiring power is lime kiln, which must be kept burning under adverse circumstances. Otherwise, it proves disastrous if the kiln dies down. In the steam of soda ash as final product, the screw conveyors get jammed due to hygroscopic nature of the chemical. Two number of continuously rotating calciners are another drive requiring for uninterrupted power and steam. In this case study provided, one number of 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator and 4200 kilowatt steam turbine generator along with three number of 70 TPH boiler are operated at around 80-85% of rated capacity. One number of 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine and one of the boiler are kept as standby to take into service either in the event of breakdown or maintenance shutdown of any of the running units. The standby is considered essential in view of critically of chemical process and to avoid production losses on this account. This captive power plant starts meeting requirement of electric power and steam of the plant as soon as the production process is commenced. With starting of process equipments in sequence, the power load increases, which provides more and more steam to process. Entire scheme is so designed that power and steam requirement increases hand in hand, maintaining good efficiency of this captive power plant. The heat balance achieved is excellent. The plant is working conforming to the concept of total cogeneration power plant technology, which is encouraged all around the world in a big way due to conformance to very vital concept of energy conservation. Next, utilization of energy available in extraction or back pressure steam. Steam injection to steam turbine at 105 kg per centimeter square, 505 degree centigrade. High pressure steam at 5105 kg per centimeter square pressure and 505 degree centigrade of temperature available from boiler is sent to a common header and from header to the steam turbine. As follows, three boilers are operated out of number 4 installed. 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator, 135 TPH, normally operated 9,000 kilowatt load. 42,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator, 28.5 TPH, normally operated at 3,000 kilowatt load. The steam turbine generates around 12,000 kilowatt electric power, which is utilized in the plant, production activity, office, area illumination, and also in the housing colony. This is the primary utilization of heat energy available in the system. Steam at 40 kg per centimeter square pressure for both 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine and 4200 kilowatt steam turbine. The steam at 40 bar pressure is taken out via extraction as follows. From 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator extraction steam, 50 TPH, 40 kg per centimeter square pressure and 380 degree centigrade, that is extraction takes place. From 4200 kilowatt steam turbine generator, that is fast extraction steam, where minimum 2 TPH, 40 kg per centimeter square pressure and temperature same, that is 380 degree centigrade. Now, this extraction steam utilization is, that is, the extraction steam is injected into three numbers of back pressure steam turbine. So, while the steam is expanding in the main turbine, it is extracted and send it to the back pressure steam turbine, which drives this. Now, this back pressure steam turbine drives the screw compressors used to compress carbon dioxide gas for sent into the processes. The back pressure steam turbine provides the low pressure steam at 2.2 kg per centimeter square, 161 degree centigrade temperature, which is taken to 2.2 bar steam header. To further optimize the utilization of 40 kg per centimeter square pressure bar steam, around 4 TPH steam is injected into back pressure steam turbine, which drives a large capacity boiler feed water pump. So, this extracted steam is again used to heat the boiler feed water, common to all the boiler under normal plant running condition. HT motor driven BF pumps is utilized only during startup of this first boiler or during maintenance breakdown of turbine driven feed pump. Again, back pressure steam turbine provides the low pressure steam at 2.2 kg per centimeter square, 150 degree centigrade temperature, which drives 2.2 kg per centimeter square pressure header for further utilization of heat in the process. The utilization of steam to drive the plant auxiliaries has resulted into substantial savings of electrical energy, which would have been otherwise required to drive very high capacity compressors and large capacity BF pumps using electric motor as prime movers. Now, steam at 22 kg per centimeter square pressure and 8 kg per centimeter square pressure used, that is deaerator steam is used. Now, these steams are in operations as, that is, from 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator back pressure or exhaust steam, 85 TPH, 22 kg per centimeter square pressure and 280 degree centigrade, from 4200 kilowatt steam turbine second extraction steam, 12.8 TPH, 22 kg per centimeter square, 325 degree centigrade. The exhaust and extraction steam is utilized as follows through 22 kg per centimeter square pressure header. Major part of steam is utilized to number of calciners for calcination process of photons. The steam is passed through D superheating station to reduce the temperature to 230 degree centigrade, which is marginal loss of energy. Part of steam is absorbed to convert sodium bicarbonate to sodium carbonate. The chemical reactions are given, that is 2NaHCO3 plus H2O, that is the steam, is equal to Na2CO3 plus 2H2O. So this heat is causing sodium bicarbonate to convert into sodium carbonate, and balance come out as condensate from calcinate. Thus, for steam used in reaction, all heat available in 22 bar steam is utilized. Again, 22 bar steam condensed, as mentioned in above, is flashed to convert 8 kg per centimeter square, that is 8 bar 205 degree centigrade steam. This steam is sent to the deaerator as pegging steam. Mostly the deaerator steam is supplied in this manner and short form. If any is supplied through 22/8 bar PRDS as and when required. This system saves good amount of energy, direct draw of steam from the boiler to deaeration is totally avoided. Some part of 22 bar steam is supplied to HP feed water heater for heating of boiler feed water before it is sent to boiler, and steam condensate available in HP heater is sent to deaerator for feeding to the boiler, and a part of 22 bar steam is directly sent to the process area for direct utilization of heat. The heat is almost utilized in the process and the condensate is recovered and sent to the deaerator. Steam at 2 bar is available from 4200 kilowatt steam turbine generator back pressure or exhaust steam at 13.7 TPH, and 160 degree centigrade temperature. Three numbers of steam turbine driving compressor where carbon dioxide is compressed, exhaust is 48 TPH, 2 bar 160 degree centigrade. For a steam turbine driving BF pump exhaust, that is 4 TPH, 2.2 bar 150 degree centigrade. The exhaust and extraction steam is utilized as follows through 2 bar header. The steam available at 2 bar from header is utilized in the process of heating purpose to its condensing temperature. As such, almost all energy available is utilized and the condensate is sent back to the deaerator for onward feeding to the boiler. Now steam draws through PRDS. A number of PRDS are installed. However, these are taken in service in the event of emergency, when steam at certain level may not be available due to non-availability of steam turbine generator or mechanical drive turbine. Except 2 and 8 bar PRDS, other PRDS are not operated under normal situation to save energy. This point is also worth nothing. Utilization of electric power. When the plant production is normal, 4200 kilowatt steam turbine and one of 1100 kilowatt steam turbine are operated, maintaining the electric power load of around 12 megawatt out of total capacity of 15 megawatt available, depending on number of equipment taken part in the process and the colony load. The grid power is kept as standby. 4200 kilowatt steam turbine is utilized to the tune of nearly 80% its respective capacity, so that the steam extraction at different level and back pressure is available, which would provide better efficiency. The variation in plant load is absorbed by 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator. If 2 bar level steam would be obtained through pressure reducing cum desulfuration station, there would be loss of heat available in HP steam sent to PDRS. Now, power plant performance analysis. Total generation output, that is 12,000 kilowatt, and if we convert it into kilojoule per hour, that will again convert it into 431,37,600 kilojoule per hour. Steam utilized are provided, that is 22 bar to process, 22 bar to HP heater, 22 bar to calciner, and 22 bar to calciner again, and 2.2 bar to process. And total energy in steam output, that is 31,81,87,425 kilojoule per hour. So total energy output, now if we summarize, that is electrical generation load plus total steam output by summing up, so that will give us 42,35,44,352 kilojoule per hour. Now total fuel inputs are given, that is earlier we have discussed, that is it is mixing with 70% with lignite and 30% of coal, and fuel flow rate and the higher calorific value of the fuels we have earlier discussed. So if we calculate that one, so total energy input will be 7487,20,294 kilojoule per hour. So overall efficiency now, output by input, that is here in this case nearly 56.6%, which is excellent one in this case of industry. So based on the plant operating data available for the cogeneration plant, the performance indicators are observed as follows. That is 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator, that is 1 or 2, that is part load, and 4200 kilowatt steam turbine generator, the 70 TPH boiler, 3 number, that is out of 4 is running, the part load, all this case, the part load are 85 to 90%, and overall efficiency nearly 57%. The data for efficiency of boiler is provided to supplement the overall very good efficiency level maintained by the plant. So as follows, the boilers, the 4 boilers, the respective efficiencies, if we calculate, so that will give us all of this, that will give us over 75%. And boiler 4, that is specially 82 to 85%, which is newly installed. The power load on the steam turbine generator is maintained to optimum feasible level to achieve the better performance. The steam load is maintained accordingly on the operated boiler, as such as plant load factor and efficiency are observed very good for this specific steam. The power load variations are generally taken care of by 11,000 kilowatt steam turbine generator maintained almost full load on 4200 kilowatt steam turbine generator, and no parallel operations with the grid is carried out. The average age of the steam turbine, that is 1 and 2 and boiler 1, 2, 3, around 16 years. The steam turbine 3 and boiler 4 are relatively new taken into service before around 8 years. So in this case, the efficiency is above 75%, which is very good one. There is a provision of online weighing scale at starting point of conveyor for measuring of actual quantity of coal and lignite fired in the boiler. Moreover, the bunker levels are also monitored. The instrumentation system for measuring the steam flow and total quantity is installed, dedicated to each boiler. Thus, necessary data for steam generation via fuel is generated for this captive power plant. For power measurement, usual calibrated energy meters are installed, dedicated to each generator. All these manufacturing and monitoring system greatly supplements efforts on the part of engineers to continuously keep a watch on the performance on this captive power plant. Now next is some heat balance sheets are shown in the next page for this plant. So this is the heat balance sheet. Heat balance sheet for cogeneration system, soda ash plant. So in this plant, that is total 3 steam headers are there as shown, as we can see, total 3 steam headers are there, that is 105 bar steam header, 40 bar steam header, sorry, total 4 steam headers are there, 22 bar steam headers and 2.2 bar steam headers. So following that 105 bar steam headers, first of all, steam is going to the steam turbines for generation. Then extraction is taken place at 40 bar steam header and 22 bar steam header also. That steam is again moving to the extraction turbine, that is back pressure turbine. And again, that one is actually using, that is moving to that 2.2 bar steam header, and further it is going to the process and deaerator. And again at 22 bar steam headers, a part of steam is bleeded out, and again this steam is going for hitting the calciner that is in the clean, and remaining part again moving to the deaerator. Now next is, that is in this case, as we can see, steam generation and distribution unit. As we can see, this is the steam generation and distribution unit, the various turbines, the valves and etc. are shown. So thank you for joining this session. Next session we'll discuss further about that, more and more case studies of current energy or current industry and more energy conservation things were actually implemented, we'll discuss. Thank you.